a big wooden structure that would collapse every year. It was about six times the footprint of this, so it was twice as wide that way and twice as long that way. Over the years, we made it smaller and smaller, and it basically ended up this footprint, so they replaced it this size. It's a lot better than it used to be, obviously, now. This is where we grow all of our plants for our sites.
North Creek 520 basically separates us from a good portion of the freeway runoff. It's like starting a project with a blank sheet of paper. They could do anything. And they wanted the site to be unique to most restoration sites.
So this is part of our stormwater system. All the drains on campus drain through the wetlands, so we have a fully self-contained stormwater system, which is pretty rare. Most places don't have a wetland to filter their water. I stopped here because it's a nice spot to look at a beaver dam, and I'm going to talk a bit just about the history of the site. So we are basically, if you go back to when glaciers came down and covered this area and then they receded, they came down to the south, receded to the north, so they carved these big valleys that were in the bottom of one of that pretty much all run north to south in this area. This is more beaver work. This swale here connects our lake to our creek, and the beavers had a house right here. They had a hut, and they use a lot of mud on the hut to seal up the air gaps and stuff like that, keep the heat in. So they excavated a bunch of mud out of this ditch. This used to be shaped like this, and the bottom was about right here. You know, this water would be this deep or something like that right now. But they've dug it to the point where it's, oh, I feel like it's deep to the bottom.
Whoa!
Like, I can't even, there we go, that's the bottom.